Okay. I'm here. I'm a little bit slow today, but yeah. I'm lazy as it can be right now, so yeah. Let's see what to say. Oh jeez. Oh, first and foremost, hello everyone. Let me go. Shoot, I need for the title and whatnot. I am out of it. But yeah, so I've been very, 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 very distracted today because, no good reason, honestly. It's Monday. I'm just feeling really out of it because I didn't have tea in the morning and whatnot. Because I ran out of tea, so I had to buy tea later. And then, like, there was a ton of Nikkei drama today. Like, a ton. Or technically started last night, but, it's been going on for hours now, and it's hilarious. That's just at the point, right? I'm not really part of it. I just acknowledge it exists. I've been like reading all these like kind of comments about it, so oh well, lots of stuff to do, lots of stuff to say. Ah, jeez. So yeah, I'll talk about it a little bit later. We can talk about Wonder Festival. Honestly, I'll put that in topics. Yay, pedal. Alright, that's the other one. Oreca battle, okay. I'm having too many tabs open. This is bad. Oh wow, I bought a whole good string hiding today. Lots of stuff happened, but yeah, let's go rant about Wonder Festival. So I'm gonna be talking over rank because I can. I couldn't put in the full title! I couldn't remember the full title! Darn it, whatever, fine.
How much did you do look at Wonder Festival? How much did you care about Wonder Festival? I don't even know that much.
Pretty interesting, but there are obviously, you know, the normal feel of like unrealistic expectations, and then there's feel with following the trends and know the trends and belong in the trends. I'll talk a little bit about what I thought about Wonder Festival. So, obvious winners of this Wonder Festival are going to be, sort of obvious? Oh wait, this is Riot? Or this High School Art? Assault Lily, oh! Checking out a bit of it? Okay. So yeah, so obviously, the biggest winner. Azure Lane. I don't think I saw any shortage of Azure Lane figures. I saw so many Azure Lane figures being announced, turned prototypes of, first colored prototypes, etc. So they showed a bunch that were already out or something like that. I have no idea. Like some of these, like Wonder Festival, sometimes a little hard to tell like what's out already and what's not. I get confused. Most people get confused. Some people obviously know the right answer, but there's stuff. That is obviously the biggest winner. Beyond that though, there was like the normal like shonen stuff. So, Kimetsu no Yaiba. Actually, Kimetsu no Yaiba didn't have as many entries as I thought. But stuff like Chainsaw Man and Jujutsu Kaisen were definitely having a lot of entries at Wonder Festival.
Alex, I welcome to the stream where we're going to be getting my Wonder Festival ranting. I'm just going to talk about random things about my thoughts about Wonder Festival. GGK and CSN makes sense. But yeah, I was surprised Kimetsu no Yaiba doesn't seem to be that hyped right now. It was a little bit... I didn't see that many entries. I might be wrong, but... it's weird. yeah, they had the arc, but I was like... Oh, is that like, what, 3 entries? Something like that? Return of King? Yeah, so I was a little bit surprised at the lack of it. Maybe I just didn't see it, because I might have just, not seen that much, but that's the way it is. It was a little bit weird. Obviously, Oshinoko is probably the big frontrunner for next big IP for, anime side, so I think that's pretty much a given. I didn't track too much of the IP fan for females, like Tokyo Revengers, like that. I know Tokyo Revengers had a lot of entries, and like you would see like stuff like Paradox Live getting a figure or something like that. Stuff I didn't really know much about. So I'm actually going to not talk too much about that because like I honestly had no idea what that thing is all about. I'm just like, yeah, figures exist for them. Yay! I don't really know how their figures look like. Yay! Because I usually don't pay much attention to them. I strangely do a lot of market research for IPs I don't care about, which is, but usually only for, you know, for IPs that are more catered toward males. So, yeah. I'll just say that much going forward, right? What was I gonna say? I was gonna say some other things, but yeah, okay. So yeah, the other major IPs. I wrote down an essay. I need to go find my essay because I need to get off because I am in like this and need help. And I care too much about Wonder Festival. I know I highlighted quest about this one, but this deserves a second mention. The Big Bird the skin you can put for Nendo on with Cookie Monster and Elmo is something else. But okay, let's go back to the other things. So I think the number one thing to take away from this, though, is that mobile games are the future of figures right now, because, yes, there were a bunch of new figures for the new Kadokawa stuff. There were actually a lot of new, like, random, like, one or two figures off for, like, popular light novels. So it was, like, you would see, like, what? I think I saw, like, 3 figures announced for Liar Liar. Blue Archive, obviously, okay, is, you know, the next big frontrunner. It seems to have, what, like, 7? I want to say 7-8 entries? I might be wrong. I think I'm lowballing it, too. It does seem to be the next big frontrunner for, like, up-and-coming IPs. It's a little bit weird just to call Blue Archive up-and-coming because it's 2.5 years and it only has, like, you know, 9 figure announcements. On the other hand, like, Nikkei, on the other hand, got, what is it? 6? Yeah, 6 announcements? Like, 6 announcements, and it hasn't even hit a year yet, which is, wild, okay? GFL also seems to be going very, very strong. Yeah, BA blew up this year, but the thing is that it took until, yeah, it, like, it also only got figures this year, too, right? So it's like, yeah, BA is very big in Japan. Like, we all know, I think we all know this. If you haven't known this, well, now you know, okay? Yeah, Blue Archive is definitely blowing up. But yeah, there was a big surprise where, like, there were also a lack of certain other mobile games.
Arknights being one of them. Arknights, I don't think it has a single entry, from my recall. Admittedly, this is a Japanese convention, so maybe they'll show up in the Chinese equivalent, but it doesn't seem like it. So I was a little surprised that Arknights is being treated like that, considering that Arknights has been making gains, supposedly? It was either three and a half anniversary, right? The character has also made record revenue sales, so, so AK is actually, like, non-existent, which is weird. On the other hand, GFL seems to be going very, very, very strong. Yay, GFL. Congratulations to GFL. No idea how GFL does it. They had, like, what, 10 figures shown up there. Something like that. I had a large figure showing, which was very, very weird. The other one that was surprisingly lacking were, Genshin and Uma. Both of them basically did not have figures being announced. Like, Uma had the two announcements that we've seen, like, forever, and, Genshin had, like, one new figure announced? One or two? Uma is very restrictive, so that was sort of leading into it, but it's still sort of weird to see that no one could negotiate a deal with Uma, considering that they should do it. It's like very strange. Admittedly, with that said, Psy Games does have a pretty interesting track record about not having figures for any of their IPs except Precon. Very strangely. Precon gets a lot of figures in comparison to any other side games IP. But with that said, GBF actually got like two new figures this year, so this time. I mean, Precon died in NA, didn't mean Precon actually died. Precon still had like two or three new figure announcements, if I remember correctly. But like Precon like historically has, I think, the most figures. Maybe GBF has like enough over like the entirety of his lifespan, but like it's like per years going on, I think Precon has more on average. So, Precon is not dead yet, as far as I know. I mean, they still got announcements. So, that's that. Cool. On the other hand, GBF did get two new figures, which was weird. And then you got some, like, random, like, one-off, like, figure IPs coming off, like, besides the light novels. Like, so we got light novels, right? So, like, King's Proposal had a figure announcement, and it's not who I ever expected to be. It's not the MC. It's not even a character from first volume, I think. Because from what you can tell, it's the second volume art. The second volume cover art, which I'm assuming is not a character from first volume. I assume. Obviously, I don't read the series because you know how little I care for the artist. Author. Artists I care for a lot, but that's gonna be an interesting one. But you'll see, like, Last Origin got a figure, strangely. For those of you who don't know who Last Origin is, which is probably most people, is a very, very, very fan servicey Korean game. Of course, it got an NSFW figure. It's not even a normal figure, it's actually filed under NSFW. I don't know, fanfare. And then there was like one other fanservice-y mobile game got a figure. That was really random. I was like, what is this mobile game? That's that. Some other things to note. Yakuza got like, what, three posable figures? Majima, is it Kiryu? And whoever the MC of Yakuza 7 was. That was interesting to see. But like, we also have the normal stuff's all there, right? Get more Kurumis. Got like two or three Kurumi showings. Toka. Like, Tsunako still is very popular. I'm not going to go over to NSFW stuff because I honestly do not know the artists that well, so I'm just like, I don't know these, and they're honestly not that appealing to me, so I'm like, okay, moving on. Yeah. So, weird surprises I saw. Other weird surprises I saw. I don't know, maybe I'm just not paying attention or not, but there seems to be, like, more Toho figures than normal. I think there were like 5 Toho figures showcased this convention. So I don't know if I'm just being just my terrible memory or Toho up on the uptick now. Finally, which is weird for me to say how old Toho is now. That was interesting. Greenheart finally has a colored figure now. That's an announcement, but we have a nice colored Greenheart now. Oh my, oh my. Actually, insane that Greenheart exists. That random stuff. There are like the other random things of like, they named Leon? Whoever the main character of Tales of Destiny? I think it's Tales of Destiny. I'm pretty sure it's not 2. 2 should be Fire Dude, right? Or the guy like long yellowish hair. But yeah, the MC of Tales of Destiny. I'm sorry I'm really bad at Destiny, okay? I'm not the best of Tales of Lore. But like, he got a figure strangely. That was a really random thing to see. But yeah, besides like the Miku, who obviously has shown up a few billion times. I need to go talk about that. Falling socks. Yeah, other ones. See. Frozen Maiden is finally completing his Nendoroid set, it seems. He got Nendoroid for what was the 7th doll's name again? And, I should probably name the 2nd doll as well now. Well, I'm bad at this. I'm bad at Frozen Maiden. I'm sorry. My memory of Frozen Maiden is non-existent, so feel bad. Is like Hinachiko? I forgot the name of the 2nd doll. I want to say something like that. I know it's like 2 names shoved together. Like, that's how I always remember her name, but I always remember her actual name. But yeah, okay. Moving on. Superstar, or yeah, Liella. It's getting probably more figures as a Love Live franchise than, or more scales than Kors or Michigaku. So it's super, 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 super weird. Okay, so yeah, moving on. So yeah, we have that, and then let's see, what else I had notes on. I need to cover almost my notes. Oh yeah, Macross got a
quite a few new figures. We got like three new figures from Macross. Maybe it's like OG Macross and Macross F. So they're really like, there's like this random nostalgia just like popping up here and there. So nostalgia is definitely becoming a bigger theme, I feel, as we go on, because there's these really pricey figures from the past. Okay, yeah, I know No Limit pretty well. I'm pretty confident in my knowledge of No Limit. Yeah, I don't think I have too many other things to say about Wonder Festival for now. If you guys have anything to say about it, feel free to bring it up. I'm willing to talk about it. I'm happy that Nikkei is getting figures. Admittedly, they're not the character I care the most about, admittedly. I don't really care for any of GFL's stuff. I'm sorry. Azure Lane, there's like a maybe chance of one or two of them are appealing, but I'm not the biggest fan of Azure Lane stuff. Like, I've seen so much of Azure Lane stuff that I'm just like, maybe this works, but not really. And I'm just like, this character is just either like too much of just like simple fan service that just feels really boring to look at, or just feels like, why not just get an SMW figure? Or the figure is just like, it's just not to my taste. So I'm just like, eh. Like, I've seen better, and yeah. I guess, like, it's weird. You're right about that, Accelerate. So, like, I don't see that much discussion about Azure Lane, but I can't deny the amount of figures it has. Like, I don't know why that is. But I also forget about, I somehow forgot about Grand Order. Grand Order is obviously doing very, very well. Oh, I don't think there's really much to say about Grand Order. It's like, yay, more Grand Order figures. Do you know this character? Oh, you don't? You haven't played the last few years of Grand Order? Oh, well. Boo-hoo. It's gotten to the point that I haven't played enough. I actually do not know some of the new figures. So I'm like, there are definitely characters I don't recognize anymore. It feels bad. I'll let Quest inform me who the characters are. And playing you for getting some of the newer ones too. Oh jeez, Quest. Oh jeez. Like, I also, like, just don't know, like, I've never seen certain pieces of art before. So, like, what was it? 7th Anniversary Kama got a figure, and I had no idea that was Kama. Like, I'd never seen that art before, so I was like, oh, that's Kama. Cool. But yeah, I did not know that was Kama. Girls be ambitious. What was this? I should know this. Oh, G Moikaku. but yeah, it's a little bit weird about just like, I always feel weird about like, weird is the saying like, you should buy like your favorite characters and whatnot for figures, because like, and not just like care just about the art, because like a lot of times I don't even know who these characters are anymore. So like, Azure Lane is probably a good prime example. I will buy, if I find Azure Lane character appealing to look at, I would want it on my shelf. I'll buy it. I don't care about the root IP. Admittedly, it's better to go care about the root IP, like it, you know, feel that attachment to the character, but there's obviously too many characters for that too, right? Metal Poneku.
Can I see you? Yeah, admittedly, you do get a certain IP by looking at the design. Except Azure Lane is probably not the one that's going to do that for me, okay? Just FYI. Just FYI, I don't like most of Azure Lane's art, which is probably the bigger issue. There is one thing about Nikkei that I do like the head artist. Head artist, I think, is a very good artist. So, that's that. But yeah, because I actually have, as I said before, I do own two Destiny Child art books on hand, and I really like the artist, or the art in it. I don't know if I like the artist on the, you know, the level of like, what the person does, so don't ask me about that one. I don't want to comment on that. I do try my best to separate the artists with like their works, because I don't want to hate a person for like, you know, doing something wrong when like their art technically hasn't done anything wrong. I'm the only hope it's Ignition. Of course. But yeah, I have some other art that's unrelated to Destiny Child or Nikkei. I do have one other piece of art from the person. And then you get this, like, same facey feel because, like, the character is, it was for the, if anyone paid attention, or anyone, like, cared super much, Siyu, which is the Korean Vocaloid, had a 10th anniversary celebration, and the artist for Nikkei and Destiny Child did the main art piece for a 10th anniversary. I have that piece of art. But if you look at that piece of art, it's like you recolored her hair. She looks like Dorothy from Nikkei. Like, there are definitely a bunch of similarities at some point. It's obviously not exactly the same, there are a bunch of small differences, but, like, I would say if you colored her hair and said she was doing some, like, small changes, you can debatably say it was Dorothy. Okay, debatable. I might be kind of crazy, but... Is this Renegade or Dimension? Is it Dimension W? It's Dimension W, right? It has to be Dimension W. The long section of just instrumentals. Like, I remember, like, Dimension W always has more techno in it. That's the only way I, like, know for sure. That's the only one I'm 100% on, right? Like, this sample, where I'm like, there's no vocals in the middle between two vocal sections, definitely Dimension W. They got a really weird sample. I don't have a mirror on the wall sample. Okay. You're taking Cuba Lever by Mayu Sagara. Easy song, right? Yeah. Um, But yeah, those are just like my thoughts, I think, so far. But yeah, I don't think I bought any, I found anything that I was like, I need to have. At Wonder Festival, I was like, there's some things I might be interested in, but I'm like, nothing, like, I don't have this, like, major urge to buy anything I saw at Wonder Festival this year, or this semester, this, what, this festival, let's say this festival, because Wonder Festival technically happens twice a year, but, like, because it happens twice a year, the company has been, like, adding in, like, mini-fairs. I say mini-fairs, but, like, they're pretty big still, like, once a season now. So, you know, fill in the two seasons that Wonder Festival is not happening in. So, like, you technically have, like, four figure festivals a year, I think, usually. But on top of that, you have, like, there's, like, a figure festival, like, dedicated, I mean, that happens in China because it's China-focused instead. So you see more owner Chinese IPs there. So, like, there's stuff that happens. Admittedly, the Chinese one, I'm, like, you know, less caring about because I'm, like, I don't follow that many Chinese IPs. So, I mean, that's that, right? So, oh, well. Just there, just to update that. But yeah, if you have anything else to say, I'll be happy to discuss it with you, because I have no one to really discuss Wonder Festival with that will, like, you know, actually talk to me about the topics I care about. I need to go find some other. Freyline? This is Freyline, right? This has to be Freyline. I looped this. It has to be Freyline, right? Freyline, please. Please, Freyline. Holy snap! 13 people know Freyline now? Why do 13 people know Freyline? This is doomed. Why do 13 people know this? Plus, do you know this? I know Nisox knows this for sure, 100%, but, Yeah, it is a short song. I fully agree on that. You saw. Yeah, it is very weird to see some of these older IPs get new figures. But as I said, nostalgia seems to be a bigger topic. Wait, is it longer? I forgot. I wonder that too. I think some people are just testing the waters to see if they think they can budget it, because you also imagine, like, international fans, because, like, I don't know if it's just internationally, but, like, I remember, like, when I used to go back for what was the Moe competition? I always forget the name of the Moe competition that started in Japan, but, like, that was, like, Untu channel name, and then grew out to that the international version, and I'm just like, what the heck? And, like, all, like, okay, Nichigo flopped Sai Moe, thank you. Nichigo flopped in Japan, too, as well. It wasn't. Oh, yeah, FOP and JP versus Global? Okay, yes. Yes, correct. Correct. Yeah. It's Love from JP, yes. You're right. So, International Taste of, like, Saimoe, if you've, like, ever watched Saimoe rankings, they're full nostalgia. Like, that thing is so heavily nostalgia-based at times, I feel. It's like, Shana's, like, forever on there. Mikasa is almost forever on there. Like, Hinakiku or Hinakaku, like, some of you feel that, like, are, like, used to, like, at least in the years I checked, were, like, on there forever. Like, I haven't done any of them recently. I've not tried, so I have no idea what the current rankings are. But I remember in the past, it was so heavily just, like, heavily nostalgia-based. It was like, wow, there's a lot of these classic characters always there. And, like, there is definitely an audience for classic characters. And, like, yeah, like, Shauna is obviously the one that's, like, stand out, right? Because, like, Shauna's like, whoa, new Shauna content! And then, like, they'll, like, try to capitalize it big and get huge amounts of fanfare, strangely. And it's ancient, right? Shauna's ancient. Not many, like, connections left, but some people have a really strong one for Shauna stuff. And so you see, like, Shauna figures now for you. So, like, I feel like some people are still testing the waters, because no one really knows. If I were to release a Shauna figure today, like, I guess that one will succeed, but let's say, I'm trying to think of an old IP that doesn't have that much, that has love, but hasn't had any real content. That's not No Game, No Life. Like, No Game, No Life, I don't understand this IP. I really don't. No Game, No Life got, like, multiple new figures announced. Sure, Toradora. Toradora is actually a good one. Yeah, Toradora is a good one. Like, if a new Toradora figure came out to be announced, would you buy it? Would you find friends that buy it? It would be very interesting to see the results. But yeah, can I remember the last time a Toradora figure came out? I'm trying to think. Was there, like, a Toradora anniversary things, though, recently-ish? I don't remember. There was, like, a Toradora anniversary-ish thing come out recently. Yeah, like, some of these, like, diehard fan bases are very interesting to see what they're willing to do and what they're not willing to do. And also, like, I think you probably heard, like, this stuff about American movies before, right? Like, American movies always had this, like, you know, recent thing where, like, a lot of them are getting, like, remakes, or a lot of them are based on old comic book heroes, etc. Because, like, the people who that was, like, you know, appealed to teenagers originally, they're all grown up now. Like, they're now all the ones with the money. So they're the ones who can, you know, spend. So it's good to appeal to them. But, like, it doesn't seem nostalgia's hitting, like, Japan as hard. Darn, it sounds hard for me. I'm a Macross reboot announcement. Who knows? Maybe at this rate. Macross, I don't know what they're doing with the IP. It's an interesting IP. Like, they'll go backward, they go forward, they can honestly do whatever. Like, I don't know what they plan to do with Macross. I actually do not know High School Girl Tucson then. I should have been able to voice it, but I didn't. I'm so bad at this. Whatever, I don't care much, as you said. I definitely don't. But yeah, it's always interesting to see how much people want to play on nostalgia. But, like, I think we're definitely seeing a lot of figure companies at least experimenting with the concept. They're not, like, jumping in full in. Besides, like, the random, like, really random, like, good smile Nendos. got some wild Good Smile Nintendo announcements. You know, Toothless from How to Train a Dragon. I'm like, where's the appeal for that? Who's buying that Nintendo? I have no clue under the sun who's buying Toothless. Someone want to go inform me about the fan base for How to Train a Dragon? Digimon 2 reboot, oh my. That's random. Oh, just can't say, okay. I am so bad at the song. I put one room on it, hell. But like, yeah, it's very strange to think about who is gonna buy this stuff. I don't know how many people are there to like buy it. It's like, whoa, we shared a prototype of this. But like, you see people come out of the woodworks, and it's like, who are you? And why do you care so much for this? I'm done. Really? I just slept and kind of good at thinking XX or not. Well, wedding dress Luis. Wow, interesting. And like, I guess like there's, you know, the other stuff like Aikatsu didn't have figures before because why would Aikatsu have figures? And like what, 2-3 years ago Aikatsu figures started showing up and some not even cheap Aikatsu figures, they're very pricey Aikatsu figures started showing up and I'm like, wow, these things are decent sought after. Very interesting to think about, right? Because like kid shows are popping up and like kid shows are gonna be, you pretty much have to depend on nostalgia for them because kids don't have money, okay? And kids also generally don't really want figures. Well, at least Quest is tempted. South of Base Hard. What is this? Yeah. Okay, who knows if what the heck we're actually doing with some of this stuff, I feel. I don't know the lyrics for this. Doomed. Yeah. We'll see what they experiment with next. But yeah, I think that's really all we can say about this Wonder Festival. I think the biggest surprises are mostly the lack of development of certain IPs. Like I said, Genshin and Numa. Like, seeing them not have, like, much presence at all is very strange. Yeah. On the other hand, I decided to go, buy a garage kit this time around. One of the people there had their garage kits up on booth, and I said, heck, let's try it. This is technically the second time I bought a garage kit, technically, but like, I'm too lazy to even do one of them, so I'm a little bit scared for myself because I'm tempted to just be lazy again, but we'll see. I've tried my not be so lazy this time around. Try not to. As you said and done. Like, yeah, Genshin's very interesting because they seem to only want figures from like one or two companies, or that, it's too hard to go make a deal with them. Something like that. I don't know what's happening there. Oilverse is weird. Like for some reason, Honkai Impact 3rd got like two new figures. So that was interesting. I don't know who made them. I don't know if it's a Chinese company or a Japanese company, but like, it's very interesting to see who can partner with what. That's always like a big question mark, right? Let's go. sucks. Okay, he sucks. I didn't get it right, but it's fine. It's like a mistake on typing. Yeah, I'm not thinking super hard. I'm trying to do other things right now. But yeah. What else there to say about it? I don't think there's. Can I say anything actually more about this? I don't think I can, right? Yeah, maybe something I could say. Yeah, so next up, right? So obviously, I think the next major thing for me then is going to be going to Canada later this month. So that's that. Hopefully that'll be fun, but that doesn't really have me talking about speakers or anything. Feels bad. But yeah, I've been trying to practice songs and not doing a good job with it, so yeah. Not great. Not going well. So we'll see how that goes. I am definitely not trying very hard. That hard, but it's looking very good. Looking very, very good. Oh, no audio. Uh-oh. Boo. Oh, audio. Bridgman, I did not know this. Okay, fine. Evelyn's curious when I got to. Oh, this is, yeah, very easy. That is doomed. Dragon Dentist, also doomed. I mean, I'm going to try Speedtune, like, I am going to try Speedtune class, except, like, after hearing more and more about who's coming there, I'm getting more and more just like, I don't think I can compete. We'll see. What do I do? Like, I think my best bet is, like, somehow get past qualifiers, which supposedly I keep hearing is not very hard, but I'm not very hopeful, honestly. But, like, the best thing I could do is, like, take a Love Live topic and, like, hopefully face someone, like, asleep or someone like that who's really bad at it and just take that title and hope I can do my best in the rest. Chances are that's not happening, just FYI. But, yeah, like, number one answer is, like, grief asleep at this point, right? It's a silly response, right? Like, I know, like, there are certain topics I'm very strong at, and a lot of topics I'm very weak at. Like, sleep is doing, like, is starting to train modern stuff. You know, this is very scary, right? Sleep's training modern stuff. He's doing his 2021 and later trainings. Stuff that sleep's not known to do, right? This stuff that sleep is just like, like, sleep is not known to be super fast on certain things like that. So we'll see that. But yeah, like, kitty grade I can do, but like, kitty grade is all usually stuck in a topic I can't do. I remember last time seeing a speed tune with kitty grade, I didn't know the four other songs. Those are a set of five songs. I'm like, I know Kitty Grade. I know nothing else. Yeah, great. GG. But, like, there's another problem where I don't know all the Machiko songs yet. Or Miku songs. You know, there's a problem there. Problem. And definitely not Hashi. Definitely not Hashi. Yeah. Like, so, I need to learn these. Like, the chance that Machiko will show up, like, on the easy songs, like, if there's an easy song that need to come up, I need to be able to answer, I need to be able to answer Machiko, okay? Like, I need to be able to answer all my Konosubas right. Konosuba might be a very likely topic. Machiko is at the concert. I mean, yeah. So, we'll see. But that's all for me. So enough talking for me. I'm ranting long enough. Thank you all for coming, everyone. Great having you all. Hope to see you again soon. Bye-bye.